I've lost count already. I think that's 9, maybe. I'm just going to cook some meatballs. We'll work out everything else later. In this video, we're going to show you a recipe for a meatball panuozzo. A panuozzo is leftover pizza dough that kind of balloons up like a pitta. Traditionally, it's filled with cured meats, but in this case, we're going to make the most amazing, cheesy, gooey, umami-packed meatballs. They're going to blow your mind. Let's get started. Right, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to make our meatballs. These meatballs are the best meatballs I've ever tasted. They're going to change your life. And the first thing we're going to do is get a pestle and mortar, and we're going to add 2 tablespoons of fennel seeds. And we're just going to give them a little pound. So we've done the fennel seeds first, just to kind of break those up a little bit before adding everything else. So after that, we're going to add 1/2 teaspoon of chili flakes and 1/2 teaspoon of oregano. And then to that, we're going to add 1 tablespoon of chopped rosemary, 2 tablespoons of panko breadcrumbs. Going to add those to the dry mix. We've got 35 grams of Parmesan here. And when that mixes with the breadcrumbs, when it melts and the fat comes out, that's going to keep the moisture inside the meatballs. The purpose of this is to keep the moistness in the meat. It's called a panade. Now we're going to add 500 grams of beef mince to the bowl. And then we've got 2 teaspoons of Dijon mustard. That can go straight in. So we're going to add 2 sausages. If you haven't got sausages, you can use pork mince, probably about 100 grams. So we're going to add a couple of pinches of salt. We don't need too much salt because there's a lot of Parmesan in there, and a good pinch of black pepper. Our final ingredient is 1 egg. So you can make the meatballs the day before, boil them up and leave them in the fridge. You could use them for pasta dish or anything else you fancy. So now it's time to boil the meatballs. We're going to weigh these guys out to 15 grams, 1/5. So we want them quite small because they're going to be going inside the panuozzo. We don't want them too big, and also we want to cook them quite quickly in Roccbox. If you feel like they're sticking a bit, you can just dip your hands in some warm water before you start. This recipe for the meatballs will make a lot more than you need for the panuozzo, so these freeze really well as well. Great to have just knocking about for a midweek dinner. Cool, so we've boiled up all our meatballs and they're ready to be cooked now. That recipe is going to make you about 48. And in the panuozzo itself, we're going to use about 8 or 9. So we've got Roccbox fired up to 500 degrees or 900 degrees Fahrenheit, and that is on full flame at the moment, and we're going to preheat this pan. We want our pan to be nice and hot because cooking meatballs in Roccbox is one of the best things in the world. We get lovely little charred edges, little crispy bits, and that middle is going to be super, super unctuous and gooey from all that Parmesan cheese. It's going to be great. So once your pan is nice and preheated, just bring it over to your workbench. Drizzle in a little olive oil. We don't need too much. There's a lot of fat in these as is. And you can hear that pan's not raging hot. It's just a nice heat. Give them a little shake and straight into your hot Roccbox. So we're gonna be cooking the meatballs for around about 3 or 4 minutes. We want them to take on that kind of crust a little bit on some of the edges. We don't want them to go dry. You can see the amount of fat that's come out of the meatballs. That's fine. That's gonna enrich our sauce. So we're gonna add kind of a few ladles of tomato sauce straight to that. So I've done about 4 ladles in there. You just give it a little stir around, it will kind of emulsify. And we don't need to go back into Roccbox now, we get a little bit of reduction just from the extreme heat of the pan. Now we're going to rip over our mozzarella. So we've got Fior di Latte here, which is sheep's milk mozzarella, but you can use buffalo. If in doubt, add more cheese. That's kind of my motto. So we're going to foil that up. So be careful when you're foiling your pan, it will be hot. It has been in a 900 degree or 500 degree oven. So we've just got a leftover dough ball here. If you're not sure about making dough, we've got loads of videos on the channel. We've got Adam Atkins' series on making pizza. We've got Mike Fitzik, the pizza Jew. We've got a Gozney own 5-part series. All of them give you amazing dough recipes. You can see how bloony this is and how old this dough is. So we're just gonna split this in half. We wanna keep the air in here. So we're gonna open it kind of gently and just press in. So just lightly flour your peel and just lift the panuozzo on. So we're going to cook this in the front half of Roccbox. We don't want it too near the back because we might find it chars and burns a bit too much. And as it balloons up, we may also find that we turn the flame down during the cooking process. Depends on your dough, temperature of the dough, all those sorts of things. Okay, so after kind of 2 minutes, 2.5 minutes, you'll be left with this pillowy joyousness. So now we just need to fill it with what is under here. So let's see how our meatballs are doing. So you can see the cheese has melted, the tomato sauce has thickened up from the heat that was left in that pan. We're just gonna rip over some basil leaves over the top now. Okay, so to cut the panuozzo, we're gonna use scissors. This is gonna be very hot in the middle, so just do be careful. And when we get to the middle, you'll see the strands of gluten. And you just wanna kind of cut through those so you open it up into a pitta sort of shape. It's time to spoon in the filling. Grab yourself a few of the meatballs, loads of the cheese, loads of the basil. Get it jam-packed with sauce because it's good. And if it trickles down your chin, who cares? And that is a meatball panuozzo. Using a few leftover pizza ingredients to make the panuozzo itself, we've then made the most incredible meatballs by grinding up all those fennel seeds and other lovely aromats, adding them to the meat, adding our parmesan, which has meant that that's stayed so moist and so full of flavour, topping it with mozzarella, sticking it in the leftover pizza dough, and making something that will probably change your life. When you make this panuozzo, hashtag us, Gozney Kitchen, Instagram, Facebook, all that stuff. We want to see what you're making and we want to see your creations. So if we look at our meatballs, you can see the amount of... You can't see me at all. Maybe we won't do that in the centre.